Okay, so now we're going to talk about releasing retainage for AIA type billings. So now that Sage has introduced the project contract billing details tab on invoices, you can see all of these available fields down here by line item. Okay, so here's my schedule of values, and here's what, you know, looks like some of the fields, or a lot of the fields that are on the AIA, if not all of them. In order to get this layout, you do need to come in here and drag and drop your columns into the order that you would like. So I added these three at the back here because they were down in the details. But you can drag and drop these in the order that you'd like. You're going to click the apply layout and then save layout. Okay, so just a tidbit there. So now that these are available, we can then use the generate invoice screen and create an invoice form that uses these totals. Okay, so we're no longer going to go into projects, retainage, or this AR retainage, same screen. You're no longer going to create the AR retainage batch, which is not intuitive at all. Doesn't look like the AIA layout. So you're no longer going to do this. You're going to go right into your generate invoice screen here. And I'm going to start over so you can see the beginning screen here. And you're going to have something similar to this filled out. Okay. If you want to get your columns displayed in a certain order, so I put my retainage balance and my retainage to bill this period next to each other. You can drag and drop these. When you get the cross, you can drag and drop your rows around and check mark and uncheck mark what you want to show. Okay, so I'm going to hit preview, go back into it. Scroll down. Don't forget to put an application number in there. If you want to call it retainage or whatever you normally do. I'm going to come down here, and here's where I'm going to release my retainage. So if I want to bill my full $250,000, I'm going to type in $250,000 right here. So don't forget that Sage Intacct does allow you to do math in a cell. So if I wanted to do just half of this $305,000, I can do that times 0.5, for example. And all I did was type 305,000 times 0.5 on my keyboard, hit enter, and now I've got my 152,500. Okay. So I have already got one created in the system. So I'm going to pull that one up. And we'll look at the form here. Okay, so I'm going to first go to page 2. And we're looking at this 28 systems line. Okay, so we're going to compare this to the input screen here in a minute. But notice that has 10,300. So I have 153,000 totally completed and stored to date. I've billed 100%. My retainage was 10%. So I held $15,300 and I billed $5,000 on my generate invoice screen. So my $10,300 is what's remaining for retainage. Okay. So let me go back to the actual invoice in Sage. And you can see my 28 systems line here. I've got my $153,000. Originally, I had $15,300 in retainage. I billed 5,000 and now I have 10,300 left. Okay. So let's go back to the invoice form. And we're going to notice on page 1, I've got my 25.261 million, my 2.247 in retainage. That should equal my totals down here, which it does. I've got my $5,000 here for my retainage that I billed. And my total earned less retainage is calculating correctly minus my previous certificates to get to the 5,000. Okay. So the front page here should match up with your totals, some of those totals on the back page. Also, one thing we did with this newer form is we repeated these column headings so that they will repeat on page two. So you have that, this item number row here and this one right below it repeating on the second page. Okay. So now we do have the AIA retainage billing form in the system. You do not need to generate any sort of difference when you do your generate invoices. You still pick the same form right here. We just need to load that AIA form, the newer one, to your printed document templates. So it hits this invoice template here. Okay. So if you are already using Sage Intacct and already using the AIA, request with us that you would like the newer AIA that does retainage. And also, if you need any assistance with the display options I've shown or laying out your invoice through the edit entries layout here, or any other assistance, reach out to us on this billing process and on this billing form. Thank you.